Is smaller always better in the world of computing? Let's find out with the Beelink S12 Mini PC. Welcome to the Mini PC Tech Channel, where we talk about all things Mini PC. This is Mike, your host. The Beelink S12 Mini PC isn't one Mini PC. It's four. The S12 comes in two flavors, each differing by the amount of RAM and storage. The S12 Pro is in the same package, but with better processor and graphics. In this video, we will tell you what this mini PC can do for a very low price, but also give you options if you want to pay a little less or get more processing power. We also provide you with links in the description below to purchase or explore these products further. The Beelink S12 Mini PC measures 4.52 by 4.01 by 1.54 and weighs around 280 grams. It comes with a VESA mount, so it is ideal to put behind a smart TV or monitor, and take advantage of its wireless connectivity features to control it from anywhere in the room. The Beelink S12 comes with an Intel Alder Lake N95 processor, while the Beelink S12 Pro comes with an N100 processor. They are roughly equivalent except for one important differences. The N100 has graphics that has more processing power than the N95. By the measure Intel uses, it's about 50% more. The N100 is also a little faster than the N95. In some benchmarks, maybe 3 to 5%. The S12 and S12 Pro each ship with two options for memory and storage. The base models of each have 8 GB of DDR4 memory and 256 GB of SSD storage. For about $30 more, you can get a model with 16 GB DDR4 memory and 500 GB storage. You can also replace the SSD to max 2 TB or add a 2 TB of 2.5-inch 7mm HDD M.2 SSD 2280 to expand the storage. This is something you would have to do yourself, but it is a great way to make this into a small network-attached storage device. One thing that the S12 stands out with is its power consumption. When it's doing a lot of processing, it only consumes 25W. Users have reported as low as 8 watts when it's idling. So it doesn't produce a lot of heat, and the combination of the ultra-quiet fan, heatsink and hard drive cooling keeps it cool while not annoying the user with background noise. It has great connectivity for a small machine, and the S12 Pro is even better. They both support dual HDMI 4K outputs, an audio port, and a 1 gigabit Ethernet. They also both have 4 USB 3.2 ports. This is twice as fast as USB 3.0. The S12 supports Bluetooth 4.2 and Wi-Fi 5, while the S12 Pro supports Bluetooth 5.2 and Wi-Fi 6. For $10 more, you might want to consider the S12 Pro if these features are important to you. One of the great features of the S12 is that it is set up to be a server with 4 features: Wake on LAN, PXE boot, RTC wake, and auto power on. That gets a little technical, so let me explain. Wake on LAN is a feature that allows a computer to be turned on or awakened from sleep mode via a network message. PXE boot allows one to remotely boot the computer through the network. RTC wake, or a real-time clock alarm, is a feature that can be used to allow a computer to wake up after shutdown to execute tasks every day or on a certain day. Finally, Finally, auto power on. This is a feature that allows you to schedule your S12 to turn itself on without human intervention. This is excellent for those who use their S12 on a schedule and want it to be ready in advance without having to leave it on all day. Before we do a comparison with other machines we've reviewed, let's look at what people think of the S12 itself. The reviews on this are mostly positive. When we last checked, it had 4.5 stars with over 600 reviews. But every computer has its pros and cons, so let's dive in. People tended to like its size and found it useful for basic computing needs, like gaming and streaming. There were some problems with connectivity, hardware failures, and Windows not restarting. One important thing to note is that no one complained about product support. Every computer will have problems. The question is, do they get resolved? And for the most part, it appears that they did. This mini PC has many uses. First, it can be used as a desktop replacement for the usual processing like writing and browsing. The S12 Pro might be a better choice for light gaming and streaming. Either one could be used as a network-attached server, though the Pro would work better in busier environments. Now let's compare the S12 to other mini PCs. First, the Beelink S, which we reviewed previously. The main difference between these two mini PCs is the processor dot and the graphics. The Beelink Mini S is an 11th generation processor, while the S12 is a 12th generation processor. What does that mean? The CPU is 20% faster. The graphics are almost triple the speed and the storage access is faster as it moved from M.2 SATA to PCIe. Check out the details in the blog post linked below. If money is really an issue, the Mini S is about $10 less than the S12. But the S12 is well worth it. Next, we look at the PELADN Mini PC. The Wisconsin 4 is comparable to the 11th generation S, and about $20 more. The Wisconsin 6 is a great little mini for the price. It's comparable to the S12 Pro, except that it uses M.2 SSD technology instead of PCIe. It also only supports the older Bluetooth and Wi-Fi like the S12 does. But the PELADN can be upgraded to 32GB of RAM as well as 2TB of storage. So, if you need the extra memory, this might be the machine for you. So what can we say about the Beelink S12 Mini PC? First, it offers a sleek design and the ability to run both Linux and Windows 11 at a great price. Second, with the 12th generation processor and expansion capabilities, it can grow with you. It is never going to be a high-end gaming PC or be able to support high-performance processing. But it probably will fulfill its role for several years. But it's a great little mini for a student, business person, or as the heart of a home entertainment center. If you like this video and want to see more like it, please be sure to like and subscribe to the channel. This is Mike, saying goodbye until next time.